Happy is very small word compared to my fear. It is like it's biggest day in my life.
A man holds his newborn child for the first time at Pearson after they escape from Gaza.
There's a yearning for peace. There's yearning for life.
Toronto Mayor Olivia Zhao calls for the return of hostages and a ceasefire in the Israel-Hamas war.
While the two people do appear to know each other, the extent of that relationship is unknown at this time.
And a woman is dead after a stabbing inside a South Etobicoke condo. We'll have the latest coming up.
The flags themselves are phenomenal to see, just phenomenal. It changes the scenery tremendously. You don't see sights like that.
Remembering those who served Operation Raise a Flag at Sunnybrook Veterans Center. Good evening. I'm Bakari Savage.
And I'm Lena Latifat. Thank you for joining us and welcome to Live at 5. An interfaith vigil is being held outside the Israeli consulate on Bloor Street this evening, where participants are calling for a ceasefire in Gaza.
And for the latest on the demonstration, let's go live to CP24's Lindsay Biscay. Lindsay. It's 5:15, 8 degrees. This is Live at 5. A woman is seriously injured after trying to intervene and check on the well-being of a group of young women. More on this is next.
And also up ahead, the latest on the investigation into the city's latest homicide, a woman murdered in an Etobicoke condo.
It's 5:23, feeling like 4 degrees outside.
Yeah, sitting at 8, though. Let's talk about that with meteorologist Chris Potter. We're going to be even cooler tomorrow and Sunday, Chris.
Yeah, it does back off temperature-wise. Obviously, yesterday and today, we basically peaked at around 10 degrees, just a touch, a fraction, if you will, above normal. The normal daytime high for this time of year is around 8. Normal overnight low is close to 0. And we're likely going to drop down towards that 0-degree mark tonight as the winds become more northwesterly. In terms of the temperatures right now, still quite comfortable for this time of year.
Well, we continue to deal with problems. QEW on the Niagara-bound side, right around the West Mall. Crews dealing with a collision, blocking the right lane. We had problems on the westbound 403 on the approach to here, Ontario. Collision was in the right lane. It cleared, and we still have issues on the eastbound 401 in the collectors approaching the Don Valley Parkway. Right lane and shoulder blocked following a stall. I'll send it back to you.
This CP24 traffic report is brought to you by 407 ETR. Enjoy the journey with a stress-free commute.
It's 5:25, 8 degrees. You're watching Live at 5. The Grammy nominations have been announced, and coming up, we'll tell you who is up for Album of the Year. Stay with us.
And we're live outside the Israeli consulate at Yonge and Bloor. This is where an interfaith vigil is being held to call for a ceasefire. CP24's Lindsay Biscaya provides our coverage.
A man holds his newborn child for the first time at Pearson after they escape from Gaza.
Indigo's flagship location at Bay and Bloor is defaced with graffiti targeting its Jewish CEO.
And more than 30,000 flags have been planted on the lawn of the Sunnybrook Veterans Center ahead of Remembrance Day. Good evening, and thank you for joining us. I'm Lena Latifat.
And I'm Bakari Savage. Welcome to Live at 5. Members of the Toronto Police Hate Crime Unit, they're investigating after Indigo's flagship downtown location. It was defaced with graffiti targeting the company's Jewish CEO.
CB24's Eden DeBebe joins us live now from Bay and Bloor with the latest details. This is a troubling trend, Eden.
All right, with that, it's 5:59, 8 degrees. This is Toronto's breaking news, CP24.
Thank you for joining us. CTV News at 6 is next. Have a great weekend.
A family separated by war, now united.
Happy is very small word compared to my fear. It is like It's biggest day in my life.
Tonight, a baby born in Gaza. A father meets his daughter for the very first time. Good evening. Amid so much heartache coming out of the Israel-Hamas war, our top story tonight is one of hope.
A family torn apart by the conflict is now back together this evening. CTV's Sean Lethong was at Pearson Airport as they were reunited today.